everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We're on to the divisional round now. Two steps away from playing on the biggest stage in sports. It's the Packers going up against the Seahawks. So now let's go to Green Bay, Wisconsin, where Jimmy Field has the target.
It's the divisional round in the NFL. That means a trip to the conference championship is on the line here today on EA Sports.
Good name's Martin and Bill Sims getting set for this divisional round matchup. Kickoff is minutes away.
Yeah, every round of the playoffs just gets bigger. Everybody gets more excited, more attention drawn. A pro season players, I should say. How do you handle? Can you keep your nerves out of the game? Also, for the coaches, can you make decisions on the sideline?
The Packers are back deep, waiting for the kick return. And Steven Hauschka is ready now to get this one started. First down at the 20. And Rodgers will hand it off. Tackled at the 29-yard line.
Eddie Lacy is the type of runner. You like to get him involved early, get him into the game. Why? Because he runs with such power and he can punish defenses. If you let him do that early, I promise you, he'll get great rewards later in the game.
Packers have it at the 29. And the field. Here's the Rodgers lined up, two tight end set. The Packers run the 37. They call his name again. Picks up about five.
Always a chess match early in the game. You see what your opponent is going to do. Good run that time by the offense. They pick up good yards. Maybe the defense will have to start crowding the line of scrimmage for it.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. First down, offense readying for the snap. They call his number once more. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. As we take a look at the offense, Jordy Nelson seems to get better every year in this league.
Jordy Nelson has been a solid player for this Green Bay offense over the last few years. Fast, big, can really go up and get those catches when defensive backs are draped all over.
After running it, it's second down. It's a two tight end formation. They want to keep feeding him the ball.
Lacy is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Breaking huddle coming to the line at the 42. John Coon carries the football. Tackle's made and the first down is picked up. First down here after the run. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Trying to beat the play clock. Dropping back. The defense gets a sack.
Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
The Packers take it from the 23. Scans the field. Nelson had it, but couldn't hold on as this goes incomplete.
He is a defensive lineman who can dominate a game, Michael Bennett.
It is all out every single play in the Super Bowl of the 2014 season. He was absolutely magnificent. He almost won the game by himself.
That is play number 10 on this drive. Lacy lines up in the backfield. Play clock's running down. And it's spun away.
The Packers put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long. And they were ready for it.
40-yard field goal attempt coming up. The kick is good. That field goal gives them a leg up here midway through the first quarter.
Makes you feel really good about what you did during the week here. Anytime you can get points on the board early in a football game, it makes you think all that practice was worth it.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff.
Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. Wilson's heading out now for his first series.
Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
The completion sets them up now for third and 7.
Tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
Lacey lines up in the backfield. Line is out. And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty. Extra tight end on the field for this one. First down at the 46. Rodgers connects with Jordy Nelson. Ball is out.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers. Are in charge of stopping a run, but not this time. The big fella, good move at the snap of the football, gets in that backfield and gets the sack.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Just a quick drop back. Almost made the catch, but the collision jarred it loose.
Nelson's really hit hard that time. I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
Lacy lines up in the backfield. The Packers will take the snap from the 40. Would have been intercepted.
Packers really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
The Packers are going to punt the football. This goes for a touchback. The Seahawks offense trying to buck the trend that's taken hold here as they come out for this next drive. Defense has taken over. Each team has been forced to punt on its last possessions.
Well, I got some information for them, or some advice, I should say, Jim. Don't try too hard, because when you go out there and try too hard to buck a trend like this where the defense is playing well, it usually leads to a mistake.
First down at the 20. And it's reverse. A tackle behind the line.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
Roughing the passer call gives the offense 15 yards and a new set of downs.
Yeah, and it was a terrible roughing the passer that time. He absolutely took two steps before he hit the quarterback. You can see when he lets the ball go. When you see him let it go,
and the Seahawks will take the snap from the 35. Lynch looking out wide. Won the winning touchdown in overtime in the NFC title game in January of 2015. Jermaine Kearse.
He showed everybody that he has toughness, he can run routes, he's got good size. That's everything you want in a wide receiver.
The first quarter is in the books, and we've seen a pitcher's duel thus far. Which defense is going to crack first? We'll be back after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade. Win from within.
We're back here to start the second quarter. And partner, when you're in a tight defensive game like this, what does an offense have to do to open this game up?
Well, I think what happens sometimes in situations like this, Jim, you know, the offense, they plan for the game and what they're going to do, but they come out there other than that first series or two, and they go, wow, these guys are better in person than they were on the field. So you've got to adjust physically.
To the end zone. The 20. The 10. Good job on the ground there by Lynch.
Lynch is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. Let's see how they back up the big play here. The Seahawks are in the end zone for the touchdown. That touchdown, partner, puts them in front here in the early part of the second quarter.
Yeah, it's nice. They scored that touchdown. The defense has got to be kicking themselves because they did not play well or smart on that scoring drive.
The Seahawks now lined up for the extra point. extra point was good. The Packers looking for a big return and hoping to find a way to regain the lead. Scores 7-3. The Packers are back deep, ready to return.
Out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down and 5. The give at the eye. And he's tackled down after picking up the first. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day.
Lacy is a very smart player. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
It knocks the ball free, and look, in the NFL, defensive backs, they got to be perfect, otherwise that flag is coming out. That hit is so well timed that there's no penalty, and it knocks the football away.
Here's the football marked at the 47.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Second down and 10. But the ball is knocked out, incomplete.
Third long situations. A lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just great.
The Packers will look to get to the 37 to pick up a first down. Quick drop back.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
Player showing no restraint, coming in on the quarterback, and that late hit will cost his team 15.
A lot of times these late hits are called, and I feel for the defensive player. Not in this case. That was an easy call, a blatant late hit. It's worthy of 15 yards.
The Packers from the 32. Here's the handoff and no run. He's taken down at the 23. He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message that shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense. By that play, I think he calls the right play, but what happens, the run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Coming to the line at the 24.
The Seahawks lined up in the nickel. They need to get the playoff.
Makes the catch in open space. That's his first reception today. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
Man's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
Rodgers' completion percentage, 40% on the day. Midway, second quarter. Jarring hit that time, knocks the ball free.
That's interesting as you watch the receiver trying to make that catch. He knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. Dropping back three. And Sherman nearly had the pick.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So here, defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
What a drive this has been. Lacy, a solo back set. Just a quick drop back.
We got to give that defense in front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
And converts on the three. Bill, I know they were looking for a touchdown on that drive, but they at least put up three midway through the second quarter.
Well, you know, that three, maybe that 3 points is going to be the difference in this game. That's how you have to look at it when you score. Don't always look at the negative. Sometimes look at the positive, and I think that three was very important.
Thomas is going to test the coverage this time. Heading back onto the field. They're out in front in this game largely because he's been running roughshod over the defense.
Yeah, you said it right. He's running roughshod. He's breaking tackles. He's outrunning people to the edge. It's his talent that's gotten it done so far in this game.
Wilson's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Man. bench is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Second and 10. Lynch is handed the football. They tackle him at the 26-yard line.
Lynch is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go.
Hey, when there's nowhere to go, that's a short game.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up. They'll throw it over the middle. And it's batted down.
Seahawks don't have a lot of options. A third and long situation. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
The Seahawks call on the punting team. They bring in the extra tight end. First down at the 30. Here's the handoff. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
That last running play was good for only 1 yard, so it's second down and 9. This will probably be the last play before the 2-minute warning. Rodgers going to take off with it. An open lane. So now as we go back to the field, we've got a good game going, and an offense is trying to close the gap before halftime.
The 41.
The Packers snap it at the 41. Rodgers going to take off with him. He's drilled as he throws.
Well, this is an easy call right now for the offensive coordinator. He knows the situation of the football game, so you give the quarterback a nice, safe play to run right here.
Here they come to the 41-yard line. Rodgers all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Third down and 10. Throws the pass. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit. Nothing like coming up with the stop in the closing minutes of the second quarter and getting that team off the field, Phil.
Yeah, you know, when you get a good stop or do something well as a football team or an offense or defense right before halftime, hey, man, it makes you feel good. You can go in there, enjoy halftime, and get ready for the second half.
No chance to return this one as that punt is headed to the sideline. Marshawn Lynch heading back out there. And Phil, he's put this offense on his back here in the early stages and carried them to the lead.
Nothing like a running back having a great game, being physical. You say all those things, you know what? We know the offensive line's having a good day, too. That's why they're leading, and that's why this running back looks great.
First down at the 20. Second down coming up. The Packers defense now is going to go nickel. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch.
Jim, in a situation like this, you just got to be smart. It's third and long. You're winning the football game. Don't take any chances. Don't turn it over. If you punt it, that might be a good play.
One half down and both offenses still searching for answers. We've got a defensive battle on our hands, and Larry Ridley is coming up next.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's get ready now to take a look back at the first half. The Packers have controlled the flow, but it hasn't given them a big advantage. The Seahawks won't care how much their offense is on the field as long as they find a way to advance in these playoffs. All right, let's roll those highlights. Seahawks have it early in the second. Lynch getting into the clear. He'll pick up more than 30 yards on the play. Seahawks still on the field. Here we get a quick pass and completion, and that is a house call. They're now on top by 4. We go to the second quarter. Rodgers by himself here, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to the 47-yard line. So that's going to do it for us. We'll send you back down to field level for some more playoff football.
Okay, Larry, looking sharp back in that studio. Thank you for that. And now we're ready to get the third quarter underway as these teams take the field. Thomas running this one out. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Seahawks offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant to this point, partner.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you've got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half.
And now here's the first snap of the second half.
The defense, they give up a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
It's first down as they head to the line. Lynch is marked down after a gain of four.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
And it's now second down and five after running it on first down. Down at the 29.
The Seahawks offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
Lynch lined up as the single back. Now first and 10.
Wilson's able to show off the footwork. Wow, what a good job. Look at those feet, like a dancer. Gets himself in very good position to throw the football. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Lynch is going to take the handoff.
Lynch is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottled him up for a short game.
On this play, he's now got 70 plus yards on the ground.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play action thing, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Ready for the kickoff. After the running play on first down, the Seahawks with a nickel look here on defense. Rodgers there, catch the ball, and he
Now you get enough of them. What does it do? 47.
It leads to a screen.
First down here. That long gain sets them up here on this play.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
The Packers now move the chains.
Well, the quarterback has such great confidence in the receiver, and why not? He's talented, and every time the football's thrown his way, he finds a way to make a catch.
Rodgers' completion percentage, 40% on the day. First down at the 27. Looking across the middle. Right there that time for the tackle. The Packers have tried to target the big tight end in the passing game. Rodgers been a big target across the middle of the field.
You said it right. They depend on him. He's one of the best in the NFL. And when you're one of the best tight ends in the NFL, they are going to find ways to get you the football.
From the shotgun. Rodgers got it. Fast, had some heat.
Back to good job that time. Moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Rodgers now completed four in a row. The one who made the big stop.
Oh my gosh, it is the worst thing you can do on the offensive side. This drives coaches crazy. When you get down near the goal line, you run the football and you lose yards. That's just not being tough enough.
Second and goal from the four. Evans all over the ball carrier.
When you get third and goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
Stepping up to the line at the 6-yard line. Aaron Rodgers back off the line. Shotgun formation. Vertical at the 6. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
A short field goal try on the way. Going to start his return. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Seahawks haven't been able to do very much offensively in this game, but the same thing could be said on both sides. Defense, the story today.
Defense has absolutely been the story. They're both dominating physically, and I give a lot of credit to the coaches. Boy, they put their players in good positions, and the players are taking advantage of it.
First down at the 24. Daniels.
see it all the time. When the offensive line can't stop the defensive pass rush, then you have your running backs hit a defensive lineman before they go out for the pass.
They go screen with Lynch. Perry's all over that offense and brings him down.
Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense is right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Seahawks need to get to the 34 for a first down. Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And they can't connect.
Matthews, one of those guys, if he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
With a chance to return this one. Keeps his legs moving. Bates in on the tackle. We head to the fourth quarter, and it's still anyone's game. We're coming down to the wire in this one, and we're back in just a moment. We're going to the fourth quarter. Defense has been the order of the day. And it's kind of unfortunate, but one of them is going to come up short when it's all said and done, Phil.
Yeah, it's been fun to watch. The defenses have dominated. I just love the way they played with so much, you know, they're being so physical and so much emotion. That's how you play defense. This has been a clinic by both teams.
Middle of the field and incomplete this time.
Holding. Defense.
The Seahawks defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel.
Look out. They're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Nelson's going to put it in. The point pass.
Packers just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
To the line of scrimmage, first down. Rodgers gonna take it from the gun. Randall Cobb has the reception. Third catch today so far.
Well, he's got talent. This receiver can make the catches when you throw it his way. And I think his talent, the way offenses are designed, and the rules of the NFL, it makes guys like him almost unstoppable. Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back, they need to make a big play here.
From the gun, Rodgers. Percentage 50% on the day. first and goal to go. Will go ground. Lacey takes the hit and is brought down. The Seahawks lead, and all you have to do is look at the turnover ratio, and that tells the story, Phil.
It sure does. And listen, everybody calls them turnovers, but let's look at this game here. I call it takeaways. They are taking the football away from the offense. What a job by the defense.
They better hurry to get the snap. Takes it out of the eye. Lacey takes the hit and is brought down after a pickup of about two.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course, it'll be a touchdown.
Only 2 yards to go to pay dirt. The defense loading up on the line, getting set for this snap. Third and goal at the two. Incomplete.
The Packers will second guess that play call. That time on third short, they throw the football. Everybody thought they were going to run it. They were trying to be too clever, and it backfired. Now it's fourth down.
Chip shot here. Puts them in a great position to win the game. The defense now will be rallying, trying to make a stop.
Okay, yeah, you know, the good thing is they got the lead. We're in the fourth quarter, but in the back of your mind, you have to think, wow, we really could have used seven, and you worry that that 3 points is going to come back to haunt you.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Have not been productive at all offensively, but you can say that on both sides today here, Phil.
Yeah, you can. It's all about the defense, and I think the crowd's kind of liking it. They like the fact when you talk about defensive struggles, where the defenses are dominating against the other team's offense, it's fun to watch because we see it so infrequently in the NFL.
Russell Wilson will take it from the gun.
Holding offense.
That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. A long field ahead of them at the 10. Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield.
When you're going against a good quarterback and receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
A long field ahead of him at the 10. The Seahawks are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Catch made by Graham, and he steps out of the field of play. That's another reception, giving him two.
In a situation like this, third ball, if you're the defense, catch him by surprise and blitz. Second half, they're losing a close game, and you get that first down, it just gives you confidence, it opens up the playbook, and it just gives you a better chance of going down the field and getting a score.
Wilson's completion percentage 70% on the day. Time is beginning to run out here midway in the fourth. Clay Matthews at the face of the quarterback.
You know you have a good defense in the NFL when you can sack the quarterback without blitzing, and the defense did it that time.
Loss of four on the play. The defense got to the quarterback, and the offense is backed up here on second down. Wilson standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Away from the ball was a flag down on the field.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
You took a few of these shots in your day, and that's a late hit on the quarterback.
Yeah, nowadays, these guys, I believe the quarterback is overprotected. This is a bad call. The defensive player, feel bad. All he's doing is his job. He still gets penalized 15 yards.
First down and 10.
Good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind in the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
First down following the long play. Wilson from the shotgun. Ricardo Rocket with the catch.
The Seahawks did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
Wilson's completion percentage 70% on the day. Second and short. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. A gain of 13.
The Seahawks, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You've got you're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win. First and goal from the eighth. Lynch looking for a lane.
Really, to me, comes down to one thing. That means you have a lot of speed on the defensive side. You can hit them before they are ready, and that's what we're doing here today.
2 minutes to go in the second half. And we're back now as the defense will try to keep the offense off the board late here in the fourth. This game is closing in on a finish, and the defense can make one play and basically. Hold on a minute. They're going to stop play and take the defense out of the last one. So they're looking to see if the ball came out before the knee was down.
I think when you look at these plays, most of the time it's pretty easy to determine. Jim, you know, it's just always a clear shot. When that knee hits the ground, you can freeze that shot and determine if it's a fumble or down by contact.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, it was called one way on the field, but now inside of 2 minutes, it was a booth review and the call was overturned.
I think if you left it up to the coaches, they'd like to the booth review them all, Jim, because put all the pressure on the officials in the NFL. That's what it's there for.
Gimme. they were thinking touchdown that entire drive, but in the end they have to go field goal. They convert here in the closing stages.
Well, I'm sure they would have loved to kick that field goal as time expired, but that's not the case. Good job of moving the football down the field, getting that field goal to put them ahead, and now the defense, go out there and do your job.
Montgomery's got it. Way out to the huddle again. And it looks like this defense could more or less wrap up the game if they can get another big stop right here, Parker.
Yep, they can't. There's no doubt about it. Now, you have the wherewithal. In other words, you can't worry about, oh, if we do something wrong, we're going to lose. No, don't think that way. Be positive and make that play.
Pass interference. Defense.
First down, pressure on every snap now. Aaron Rodgers will be under center. First down at the 45. Rodgers got it. Numbers on both sides of the ball, they're just not there. The coverage has been good, and it's been hard to move the ball against those secondaries.
Yeah, good job for the defense today. They got a good pass rush going. The coverage has been good down the field, and also the defense has been good, but the quarterback has not been real sharp.
The Packers snap it at the 41. Rodgers gonna take off with it. He's got the catch. Packers had a moment to breathe and now huddle back up while they're right now in field goal range. The Packers come to the line of scrimmage with two timeouts to play with. After the long game, let's see what they do here. Three-step drop. Jordy, that's a touchdown! That's a touchdown! What a time in this game! We have a late lead change on that touchdown pass in the red zone, but this game probably still has another twist remaining with plenty of time to go.
It's been a crazy day, no doubt about it, but in the red zone nowadays, so many big receivers, quarterbacks so accurate, very hard for the defense to stop those passes. So many things to think about on the defensive side, but they were ready that time.
Mason Crosby ready for the kickoff. Taking the field, and this has to be the make or break moment in this ball game, Parker.
And I'm sure he is not worried about that, Jim. We've seen him in this situation so many times, and I'll say this, most of the time he comes through and gets it done.
The Seahawks have saved all three of their timeouts. We're here in the fourth quarter. Wilson's ready for the snap, empty backfield. First down at the 20.
Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management. Snap that football.
The Seahawks are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. The Seahawks will have third and long coming up now. They obviously need a big conversion here, trailing late. Third and long. Big spot here as they trail late. Third and a long way to go. Mike Daniels with the sack. Here is not an option. They've got to go for it. On fourth down late in the game. Produce the conversion on fourth down in all likelihood signals the end of their last chance to win this game.
In situations like this, I know the coaches and his teammates all expect him to come through, but not that time. Just not a good call.
Hand off, out of the eye formation. The Seahawks stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. Back out there for action after that defensive timeout. Breaking huddle at the six. Second and goal from the six. Hand off. Lacy takes the hit and brought down. This one goes for only a yard.
Jim, that's just playing it by the book. You got the lead, and you want to keep the clock moving, so what do? You run the football. When you're in the huddle, as a quarterback in this type of situation, you just tell everybody two things. Stay in bounds and put two hands on the football.
One team has secured its spot in the conference championship, while the other disheartened to know they were this close to the NFL's Final Four. All right, Phil, after this win today, they're now one step away from going to the Super Bowl. This victory today in the divisional round.
It's exciting times, Jim. This is, you know it, soon you go out on the field for warm-ups, you go, boy, this is different. It's special. And if you could just put 60 minutes of solid football together, you get a chance to go to the Super Bowl.
And all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.